Hi, I'm Aaron. Now, today I am reviewing the Cat 2-pack, the MMPR Pink Ranger and the Power Ranger Zeo Pink Ranger. Now, the reason they've brought them out together is because both the same range. Cat was both rangers, obviously, when Kimberly left. Or actually, just before Kimberly left, Cat came into this. And do you know, I wasn't originally going to get this pack. But the two things that kind of made me get it in the end was, one was I could complete the the Zeo team, finally, and two is, other than the metallic armor MMPR Pink Ranger, who was Cat, well, both actually, it was Cat and Kimberly, I didn't have a Cat as the Pink Ranger figure. So I got this pack for those two reasons. And one other quick thing is, I will put the link to this pack down below if it's still available on Hasbro Pulse. And at the time when I got this, it was, I think it still might be, 54 quid, and so this is the box. You can see the window with them in it, and on both sides it's got their Rangers, images of the Rangers. On the side it's got Zeo Pink on one side and MMPR Pink on the other, and on both sides it has the logos for the show, actually. And this is the back. You do get some pretty cool accessories with these figures, including, which I'll get out and show you in a minute, PC Park Cat, which is obviously Catherine. When she first came in, she was under Rita's spell and she was a white evil cat with green eyes, which I believe they've given it green eyes on this. So I'm first reviewing out of the two pack the MMPR Pink Ranger slash Cat. That's the Pink Ranger. Now, tell you something, I worked out just before I started this, is the top part is a completely different colour to what's on the helmet, which is a little bit bizarre, but who knows with Hasbro what they were thinking. But I absolutely love this. Now, I'm not, one thing I'm going to say right off the bat here is I'm not going to do the articulation because it's exactly the same as the other female figures. But one thing I am going to point out again, like I did with the, can't remember which Ranger it was now, but the arms are stupidly skinny. I'm going to hold it. And as you can see, the arms are stupidly skinny and very stiff, by the way. Which I don't understand why Hasbro do them as skinny, because it's not natural. It's, they were never that skinny in Power Rangers. And, well, the arms weren't anyway. But, yeah, I don't know why Hasbro do that. It's got her, and she's got her weapon holding hands on her at the moment. And, which is kind of weird, because normally they put the karate chop hand and the kind of fist hand on her, or on these figures in the boxes. And also, the detail on this is perfect, and it's all correct. The one thing that is a little odd, is, as I pointed out at the beginning of this, is the top half being a different shade. That's a little bit weird, but it's no biggie. And one thing I've just noticed again, I noticed this on a previous female ranger I did, they've not painted the inside of the holster, which really is bizarre. And the diamonds on the boot are absolutely fantastic, on both boots. The joints are really stiff, so be careful of those, and warm them up, because that does make them easy to bend. Another thing I'm going to point out is this figure, as all the other Lightning Section figures do have holes in their feet for stands. Now, my luck so far with these round stands has been terrible. None of my figures so far have stayed on these round stands without doctoring them somehow. The stands, I mean, not the figures. So, I don't know what's going on there, whether it's bad luck on my part, or the holes aren't quite right on the feet, I don't know. I know Bruno from MPR Toys has said not all of these figures work on those round stands, but so far, all of the figures I've tried have not worked on these round stands without doctoring it. And the helmet is perfect, besides being a slightly different shade to the chest, which I think this shade is correct. But yeah, the attention to detail on this helmet is fantastic. Turn it around, show you the back. This is the back of it. Also, this is a new helmet sculpt. This is a brand new helmet sculpt. For those of you that didn't know that, this is a brand new helmet sculpt. And I believe, I'm not 100% sure on this, I believe this also might have the new ball joint Hasbro is either designing or has designed. But, yeah, I will take the head off and show you the, put the civilian head on this figure after I've talked about the accessories. Again, I'm not going to do the articulation because it's the same. But, yeah. This is the power bow, which is exactly the same as all the other power bows, except the cel-shaded one. Because obviously the cel-shaded one is a purpley pink, and this is just its normal colour. Now, it doesn't have, as all the others did, doesn't have Power Rangers, or if you're a Sentai fan, Zoo Ranger on there, or Jew Ranger, I should say, should have that written on the red bits. And so that's a little bit of a shame, but then even in the others, this is bendable, but only to a certain extent, so don't try and bend it too much because you will snap it, and you don't want to do that. So be careful, and I do have the arrow, which is there, which I have an issue with these arrows. They are not the right colours at all. Perfect design looks just like the way it should, but it's not the right colour, and I do wish Hasbro would fix that, because it's such a simple thing. So, yes, that is my issue with the arrows. And again, this is quite bendable, so be careful, because if you bend it too far, it will snap. So that's just a warning. And the other accessory I have are the Blade Blaster, which is upside down at the moment, which is here. Now, again, I have an issue with this. Paint detail is fine. The whole design is fine, except they don't give you the damn folded down one or the one with the blade out. And that really bugs the hell out of me. I seriously don't know why Hasbro do it. It really does bug the absolute hell out of me. Also, one thing I've noticed with pretty much all of mine so far, which I have been able to sort out, this bit always comes slightly bent. Now, I don't know whether that's the way it's in the packaging or the way you literally have to force it out from the packaging, but it always comes a little bit bent, which isn't a biggie for some people. It's not really a biggie for me. It's just, and she that he had sex. So, here is my dreaded hand, which is the goddamn karate chop hand again, which, Jesus, this annoys me. Why not either do a completely different hand, or a different style of kind of a karate chop hand, because with every single figure you get one of these hands, and it drives me absolutely mental. I mean I'll pick up the other one for a minute, sorry PC. If I can get hold of the other one, that is. The other one is a fist hand. Why not give you another fist hand? It just makes no sense to me. I'll pick up the finger again, right, just to show you the hands that are on her. These, I believe, are her weapon-holding hands. Now, you do get these also with every single finger, but I understand why you get these with every single finger, because they have to hold their weapons. So, I'm fine with that. It's just the damn karate chop hand. Now, I'm going to show you the civilian hand now. One of the civilian hands, because this is a two-pack. Now, this is the MMPR version of Cat's civilian hand, which I actually think looks relatively like her, actually, which I know it's kind of hit and miss with these Hasbro figures, but this one actually looks quite like her. The only thing that is slightly weird to me is the hairstyle. She should be blonde, and this doesn't look blonde to me. Don't know what colour this is, but it's not blonde. She should be blonde. So that is a big mishap on Hasbro's part. Again, I wish the design team would step up their game on some of these, because one of my things I got recently, I've also had a problem with, which I am going to do a review of, which I will explain what the issue was in that review. And I'll show you PC in a second. But one, this is to do with the Zeo Pink Ranger. And also, I personally would have done this pink on my... If I was the design team, I would have done this pink. Not green. So, yes, personally I would have done this pink. So, One last thing, I will show you PC, which is Park Cat, as they called her in Power Rangers. And I love this. I absolutely do. Looks amazing. The eyes are really creepy. She does stand, but it is, can be quite fiddly to get her to stand because of the way one of her legs are. But yes, she does stand. And I think it's a great touch that they included PC. Because to be honest, I was hoping they would have, but I didn't think they were going to. I'm very pleased they did. So, anyway, let's switch over to the civilian head and I'll show you the civilian head. So this is Cat with the civilian head on as the MMPR Pink Ranger. Now, on a closer look at the head is blonde, but it's more of a caramel blonde. Could have been a bit lighter. Which I really wish Hasbro would have thought of doing that, because I know for a fact from some of the live streams that I've done in the past that they do watch some of the episodes to make sure they get the looks right. Because I remember when they were showing this pack in the live stream, they brought up a picture or a clip of a video of Kimberly and Kat, or Aisha and Kat, one of the two, with PC, and they'd shown that, and they've got PC right, perfectly right, and they've actually got the main head sculpt right. It's the hair. But from that live stream, that shows that they do watch some of the episodes. So with them watching some of the episodes, they should have got this right. And to be honest, I'm not the only one to think that. There's one other person I know that thinks that too, actually. So I really wish they to pay more attention to detail. Now the actual main figure itself is a great figure, and the head sculpt itself is a great head sculpt. It's the hair which is the downfall. But yes, this is her with the MMPR version of Cat's head on, which again looks absolutely more phenomenal. Sorry, can't help myself. So yeah, this one looks absolutely phenomenal. Sorry guys, I'm going to say it again. More phenomenal. So let's move on to the Zero Ranger one, shall we? The Zero Ranger figure. So We are now on to the second figure of the two-pack, which is the Zeo Pink Ranger. And right off the bat, there's two things I'm going to point out. The body is a slight different shade again. Not by much, but it's a slight different shade. And the other thing I'm going to point out straight away is I've also got PC out still, because so anyway, onto the accessories. So she has her pink power shield, I think. So on that is absolutely fantastic. I have one issue with this figure, though. Oh, with this accessory, though. The outside kind of blade bits. Don't know what you'd actually call these. I would say blade or rim bits. Should be silver, and they're actually grey plastic, which really annoys me when they miss out on so simple again. And also, the plastic is almost, the grey plastic is almost see-through, which again really annoys me. But the attention to detail on the front of it is amazing. I'll show you the back. This is the back here. Now, this bit here, this little stick bit, does go up and down for part of the posing. And also, there is a, what I believe, it's a little kind of bit that clips onto the arm there, or a little clip bit that will clip onto the arm, so she can kind of hold it. But yeah, that's the pink power shield, and I'll show you the effects piece, which is this kind of see-through purple, which again looks fantastic. Again, if I hold it like that, if I hold it like that, it looks like two fingers. Sorry guys, can't help myself. Or actually two alien ears. Now this does flip onto the pink power shield. I have no idea how though, but it does go on there. But I have no idea how. But anyway, it's a great effects piece. Glad they included it, and it actually might be a new sculpt of an effects piece. I could be wrong, but I don't remember ever seeing this sculpt before. So I think it's a brand new one. Now, I'll show you the other accessories. I'll show you her other weapon first, or the big weapon, which is the Zeo Power Pod Sword. Try saying that without your teeth in. which they do use as weapons, But now, the another thing that annoys me with the CRHs, with the figures, is they don't give you the folded down version to actually go in the holster. They only give you this version, which can go in the holster, but it looks like she's got a giant grey pole going down her leg. But I guess I can't complain, at least they still include it. And this bit is quite flexible, so you need to be careful you don't break it. But the detail on this thing is absolutely amazing. And this is the Zio laser pistol, which is the same as what you get with all the other Zio Rangers. And I do believe that the effects piece, the purple effects piece, can go into the end of this, but I'm not 100% sure, so don't quote me on that. Now, I'll move on to the hands. Oh god, they've done it again. Giving you the damn Karate Chop hands. Or at least Karate Chop hand, because they never actually give you two. Thank god. So, yes, this is the Karate Chop hand. And the other hand they give you, which you do get this with pretty much every finger as well. But I don't mind this hand because it's a fist hand, which is actually good to have for a finger. And this is the other fat civilian head, which again looks pretty much like her. And actually, I do actually think this looks like her pretty much. I mean, there are some off bits. It does have kind of a ponytail scrunchy sort of thing, like she had on Zio when she didn't have it flat, which was very occasionally. So yeah, those are the accessories. I'll move on to the figure really quickly. Again, the arms are super, super thin, unnaturally thin. I seem to say this about all the female figures at the moment. I'm not going to do the articulation because it's exactly the same as the others. One thing I will point out, just make sure I got it correct, is, again, they've done the silver rim on the helmet instead of the white one, which on blue, pink and green, I think they've now done the silver rim, so I gotta mend that, or not mend it, but fix it, do the trim white, which that again is so simple, has broken it quite easily. Corrected that. They wouldn't even have to do new helmets. They would have just had to paint these bits. But yes, again, it's a bit of a letdown, unfortunately. She does have a skirt, obviously, which is flexible to a certain point, but it can only get so far and then it will stop. But attention to detail on her is fantastic. Absolutely fantastic. Except the silver on the trim and all that. Put the civilian head on now and show you. And I think also, I could be wrong on this as well, I think this one has the new Hasbro full joint they designed. So I'll put the civilian head on now. So I've got the ZO Pink Ranger with the civilian head on, the cat ZO Ranger version of the head, which looks amazing. It's just a shame about the blonde hair, well, blondy caramelly hair. It should be blonde, but it looks more caramel. Looks fantastic. And I do know, I don't know if they're doing this now, but watch out for the thing that Catherine Sutherland and Nakia Burris do. Because sometimes they do giveaways. So yeah, watch out for their thing they do. Power Rangers playback on YouTube. I will put the link to their YouTube channel in the description below. And I'm just going to say this now because I have had in the past people ask me whether I get asked by some of the Power Rangers to actually pump the channels up or the actors up themselves. And the answer to that is no. I do it because my love of Power Rangers, and also because I like the actors, not because I've got asked by them. Now, if I did get asked by them, I would do it, but I haven't been asked by them yet. So, no, I haven't got asked by them. So, it's just to let you guys know that. Anyway, this is CEO Pink Ranger with the civilian head on. All in all, love this pack. I just wish there were some bits that Hasbro would, pardon my French, get their ass in the gear over. Because it's, they're minor things that Hasbro could sort out quite easily. One quick thing actually, which, this is really weird, actually, what I'm going to show you. ZO Pink is the only one out of all the ZO Rangers to actually get black on the bottom of her boots. None of the other Rangers have that. The bottom of their boots are just white. And also, they're flat. The bottom of their boots, whereas these ones are slightly raised. So yeah, weirdly enough, she is the only one to get flat on her boobs. I don't know why, whether there's a reason for that, but I'm guessing there must be. And again, she does have the holes in her feet. But yes, my ratings for this two-pack, 10 out of 10, except the issues. So, yeah, that's the end of this review. Thanks for watching. I'm Aaron.